Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. My dear students, welcome to your Fanatics class. And today is our 10th class. In our 9th class, we have talked about the different kind of topics. They are important topics. The strong and weak syllables. And we differentiate between the weak and the strong. We have also talked about the schwa. And we said that most frequent vowels in English are weak. And we said that every syllable has a schwa, is weak, is necessarily weak. Also, we said that the weaknesses of English syllables is not only distinctive only to the schwa, but also we have some other vowels. They might be existed in weak syllables, and also like U, U, and E, E, and L. So we have called these also weak syllables. They might be weak syllables when they might come in weak syllables. Okay. Also, we differentiate between the weak and the strong syllable. We said that the weak syllable is shorter than the long syllable, than the strong syllable. The weak syllable is also less louder, okay, and it has less quality than the strong syllable. So we have talked about this stuff, and then we have moved to another topic, which is called the stress. And we have defined the stress as a relative emphasis on a syllable in a word, or maybe in a word, on a word in a sentence. Today we're going to focus on the topic and to concentrate on the topic of stress. We're going to talk about the stress within a word. Maybe at the end of the class we will also talk a little bit about a stress in a sentence. But in the coming classes, we will talk in depth about the stress in a sentence. But today, we will focus mainly on stress within a word, the nature of the stress, levels of stress, and then we're going to have kind of a practical class. And I promise you, it's going to be that half of the class is going to be practical. So we're going to talk about placements of a stress within a word. We have the suffixes. Do you know the suffixes? Suffixes is a group of letters that we add after the root. The prefixes is a group of letters that we add before the root word. Compound words, that words come together. We have also word class pairs and variable stress. We will talk about this by the time. First of all, a stress. Stress, as we have said last time, a sound or syllable which is stressed is one upon which there is expended in the articulation relatively greater breath effort and muscular energy. So stress sounds, in the Swiss sounds, we spend too much effort to say it. We use our muscular, we spend muscular energy to say it. In voice sounds, a greater amplitude of vibration of the vocal folds together with the reinforcing resonation of the supraglottal cavities result in the physical terms and relatively great intensity of the sound or syllables. Such intensity being perceived by the listener as a greater loudness associated with the sound or syllable. Hona, yani hina, is kind of a abbreviation, it's kind of a summary for the whole process or the nature of the stress. So, in voice sounds, it says that there is a huge number, a lot of vibration in the vocal folds. Had a vocal, a great vibration, result in a physical term, great intensity of the sound or syllable. هذا معناته stress. It means great vibration of the focal folds for one syllable. So we spend too much energy, muscular energy, we spend too much breath efforts to say it. فهمتوا شو معنى stress syllable؟ The syllables are the sounds that in which we spend too much breath effort and muscular energy to produce it. هذا معنى stress sound or stress syllable. Generally, the nature of the stress is generally defined as the speaker using more muscular energy than is used for the unstressed syllable. شو هو unstressed syllable? In weak syllables. بينما stressed syllable, strong syllables. The muscles used to expel air is more active, producing higher supraglottal pressure. Okay? The muscles used to expel air is more active, producing higher supraglottal pressure. So here we are talking about what? Here we are talking about stressed syllables. In the stressed syllable, in the strong syllable, we expect more air than in the weak syllable. In the strong syllable, the muscles of the tongue is actually more active than in the weak syllables. In the strong syllable, we use more muscular energy than in the weak syllable, in the stressed, unstressed syllable. And we said that the stressed syllable are more prominent. شو يعني more prominent? They are recognized easily, clearly recognized. You can realize them quickly because they are more prominent than the unstressed syllable, because they are more louder, because they are more longer, because they are more longer and louder, they are prominent. They are heard. هذا معنى this is what we mean by the stress and unstressed syllable. Okay, stressed syllable is more prominent. In stressed syllable, we spend more muscular energy. In a stressed syllable, we actually the muscles expel more air. The muscles are more active. لكن في الweak or unstressed syllable, the muscles are less expel less air, the muscles they are less active, the muscles they are less longer, they are less louder. Okay. Also, we said that the stressed syllable are more prominent than the. So the stressed syllables are more prominent than the unstressed syllable. Okay, what makes a syllable prominent? There are certain factors, هذا أخذناه في المحاضرة الفائتة, that make a syllable more prominent, and these factors often to coexist to give considerable perceptual effect. The first one, stressed syllables are often louder. وهذا حكينا عنه في المحاضرة وحنكرر اليوم في لاحقا. We said also stressed syllables are made more prominent by its length, longer than the short syllable, the weak syllable. صح؟ حكينا stressed syllables are longer than unstressed syllables, longer than weak syllables. The pitch of the stressed syllable is noticeably different from other syllables. Gene pitch, here rising, falling. Teacher. هذا معنى pitch, ارتفاع الصوت أو انخفاضه. Stressed syllable contains a vowel which is of different quality from other vowels. From other vowels and here weak forms. Stressed syllable does not have weak forms. you can go to Peter Roach, the book that I have assigned, and you can have a look at the week at the weak forms on page 112. You can go back to your textbooks. We have talked about the weak forms, but if you want to know more, just go back. However, if you don't have the textbook, these our recorded lectures are barely are enough actually for unsatisfied. They are satisfied, okay? But if you want to increase your knowledge, if you want to get more information, just go back and try to read more. Levels of stress. Many levels of stress depending on the length of the word, not just confined to two or three levels. The word around, on the second syllable, the pitch of the voice, the pitch of the voice does not remain level but falls from a higher to a lower pitch. How to transfer one? The prominence from this pitch transition is called primary stress, and we have a primary primary accentuation. وفي عندنا شيء اسمه secondary stress, weaker than primary stress but stronger than an unstressed syllable. مثل examination, photographic. Okay. So if you look at the word around, 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 the second syllable, around, around, the second syllable, هو هذا, the pitch of the voice does not remain but falls from higher to lower, huh? Around, around, around. هذا المقصود فيها انه ارتفاع وانخفاض. هذا المقصود في البيتش, to go, to rise, to go up and go down. The prominence from this pitch transition is called primary stress. Primary stress. لكن في عندنا إشي اسمه secondary stress. Weaker than primary stress but stronger than an unstressed syllable. Photographic, photographic, photogra, 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 photo, the primary, gra, لأنه بعد الـ IC, graphic. هذه أخذناها القاعدة في المحاضرة في ذاك الجدول. Today we're going to talk about these examples in depth. Placements of stress. We said, how can we know the correct syllable to stress? For example, can we say camera, camera, or camera? So how can we know the correct syllable to stress? كيفنا نعرف وين لازم نحط الستريس? The word in English is morphologically complex or simple. هذا أول شيء لازم تعرفوها. إن الكلمات في الإنجليزي ممكن تكون simple أو complex. In other words, it does have one or more affixes, or is it a compound word? تعرفوا شو هي الأفكسز اللي أخذناها prefix, أخذتوها prefix, suffix, infix. هذا أخذتوها في الإنجليزي كثيرا, prefixes والsuffixes. فأول سؤال بنسأله أو بنطلع, is this word, does this word have a prefix or a suffix or infix? Is this word a compound word? اليوم نستوضح ما معنى كل واحدة منها من هذه الأشياء, affixes or compound words. بعدين نسأل أنفسنا, what part of speech? خلنا part of speech كثيرا حدثنا عنه في المحاضرات وفي المواد السابقة السنة الأولى والثانية والثالثة. Part of speech اللي هي noun والverb والarticles والadjectives والadverbs والconjunctions والinterjections والtenses. هي نام ولا فيرب؟ هذا السؤال الثاني. أول شيء بنطلع does it have affixes, infixes or suffixes, does it have a compound word, is this noun or verb. أيضا we should actually consider the number of the syllables. Does this word have two syllables, three syllables? Finally, we should consider phonological structure of the syllable. Even if you want to know the correct syllable to stress, you need to pay attention. You need to ask yourself these four stuff. Is it a complex or simple? Does it have affixes, or is it a compound word? Is it a noun or a verb? Is طبعا ترجع للword. How many syllables does this word have? If you answer these questions, you will come to know where to put the stress. You will come to know which syllable must be stressed. I said must because this is a rule, this is a law, and we have to follow the rules, right? Here we have kind of examples now. From this slide till the rest of the class, we'll be having kind of different examples. At the end of this class, we will have a chart. We will be having a chart, or maybe one chart, like two or three charts, explaining or outlining the rules of word stress and sometimes sentence stress at the end. لاحظوا, if two syllables, if we have two syllable verbs, basic rule, إذا عندنا فعل في مقطعين, البيسك رول, القاعدة الأساسية, the second syllable is accented. شو يعني accented؟ حكينا عنها, معناتها stressed, نفس الكلمة. stress و accented نفس المعنى. مثال, invent. invent معناتها يخترع. invent, وين جاء الستريس؟ في المقطع الثاني. reform, وين جاء الستريس؟ في المقطع الثاني. If the final syllable is weak, then the first syllable is accented. لاحظوا الآن نحن نحكي عن الفعل الآن نحكي عن الفعل اللي فيه two syllables. القاعدة الأولى حكينا فيها إنه بشكل عام the second syllable is accented. لكن القاعدة الاستثنائية بتحكي if the final syllable is weak, شو يعني weak؟ كان في شوى, then the first syllable is accented. مثل كلمة open. open لو بيجي نعمل phonetic transcription تاعها بتكون كالتالي open open او e, فهي o pen o pen. الo اقوى من الpen لانه الpen فيها weak vowels. inter in ta. how many syllables? two. هذا فعل. الأصل إنه يكون الستريس في الفعل في المقطع الثاني, لكن الجواب هنا لازم يكون الستريس في المقطع الأول. لماذا؟ because the second syllable has a vowel, have a schwa. okay. cool. so here we're talking about verbs having two syllables. كانت أول قاعدة هنا إنه the second syllable is accented in verbs. أخذنا مثال invent, reform. okay. لكن إذا كان if the final syllable of a word is weak, then the first syllable is accented. مثل enter. okay. أيضا في الأدجكتيفز they have the same rule. With nouns, if the second syllable contains a short vowel, then the stress will go to the first syllable. If not, it falls in the second syllable. Okay? So if the second syllable contains a short vowel, then the stress will go to the first syllable. If not, it will fall on the second syllable. لاحظوا, husband, husband, husband. وين جاءت الستريس؟ في البداية. ليه؟ لأنه في عندنا هنا short vowel. Husband. لاحظوا كيف هي تكتب هكذا. Husband. هذا short vowel, weak vowel. So the stress بيجي في المقدمة. Placard. 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 Window. 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 هذه O. والO حكينا اللي هي من ال weak forms أيضا. تحدثنا على إنه الO window والO والO والE والE هي بالعادة بتكون weak forms. Window بتكون الصرف في البداية. Balloon. بالون. بالون. لاحظوا بالون هي the stress should be on the second. So if the second syllable contains short vowel, then the stress will go to the first syllable. If not, the fall it fall on the second syllable. لاحظوا هنا في عندنا long vowel. لكن في المثال هنا الO كانت short vowel. فإذا كانت المقطع الثاني في short vowel مثل window, the stress بيجي في المقدمة. لكن إذا كانت الكلمة فيها المقطع الثاني long vowel, بكل stress عليها. Okay. What the stress patterns we have if a word have a verbs have three syllables. هلا بدنا نحكي عن verbs تحتوي على three syllables. So with verbs have three syllables, is the final syllable, the final syllable is strong, then if the final syllable is strong, it will be stressed. If the final syllable is strong, شعن strong, it doesn't have أشوى. هذا معناتها. إذن هي بتكون stressed. Entertain. Understand. لاحظوا كيف understand. لو بدنا نعمل transcription لإلها. Understand. هذه فيها شوى وهي تتكون من ثلاث مقاطع three syllables. فبيكون stand اللي عليها the stress. Entertain the same thing. I will do also entertain right here. Entertain. وهذا هو ال stress syllable. لكن if the last syllable is weak, stress will be on the preceding syllable if it is strong. لاحظوا مثل كلمة encounter. In. In. أو هذه تكتب كالتالي. In. Cow. Count. Encounter. Encounter. لاحظوا إذا كان ال final syllable هو الضعيف, if the both if the last syllable, هذا هو last syllable, إذا المقطع الأخير is weak, stress will be on the preceding syllable, حيكون على المقطع اللي قبليه, preceding معناها السابق. So if the final syllable is weak, لأنه هنا weak لأنه في شوى, so the preceding one is stressed. هذا القاعدة الثانية, إذا كان الفعل ثلاث منقاطع. Okay. طيب. If both the second and the third syllable are weak, the stress will go to the first syllable. Parody. لاحظوا. Pa. Ra. Day. Parody. Pa. Ra. Day. حكينا if both the second and the third syllable are weak, وين بروح الستريس؟ على الأول. لاحظوا الثالث كان في اي, وحكينا الاي والاو والاو أضعف من كل الفاولز لكن أقوى من الشوى. بعيد وبكرر, الاي والاي والاو والاو هذول أقوى من الشوى, لكن الأحرف العلة كاملة أقوى من هذول كاملين. فلاحظوا الآ أقوى من الشوى وأقوى من الإي, فبيجي الاسترس على البا. Parody. فالثالث ضعيف, second syllable ضعيف, الأقوى بيكون ال first syllable. The third is weak, the second syllable is weak, the third one takes the stress. فهذه هي قواعد we have for the verbs that have three syllables. أول قاعدة حكينا if the final syllable is strong then it will be stressed. ثاني if the last syllable is weak then we stress the preceding one. اللي قبليها هذا في حال كان ثلاث. بينما إذا كان the second and the third syllable are weak then we should the stress will go to the first syllable. هنعمل تمارين أكثر إن شاء الله في المحاضرات القادمة عن هذا المسائل, لكن الآن نأخذ القواعد واحدة واحدة, والمرات القادمة for the coming classes we'll be having practical classes, so I want you to open the minds and just be aware of what we are going to say. Word stress pattern. الآن نحكي عن النونز. We're going to talk about nouns. If the nouns have the three syllables, شو هي القواعد؟ القاعدة الأولى if the final syllable is weak, okay, then or ends with the schwa, then it is unstressed. هذه هنا مقصود فيها schwa. So if the final syllable is weak or ends with the schwa, then it is unstressed. If the syllable preceding is strong, then the stress will go to the middle syllable. Okay, so if the final syllable is weak or ends with the schwa, then it is unstressed. خلاص, final syllable unstressed. هذا final, لأنه عندنا إحنا three syllables. Okay, the final syllable is stressed. Okay, and then if the syllable preceding this is strong, then the stress will go to the middle syllable. حيكون في second syllable. في أعطانا مثال مثلا 11 أو potato. potato. Okay, شوى weak, الA أقوى, strong vowel, long vowel, دائما strong بيكون longer. A potato. هذا short, هذا لونج. اي اي او او. مرة أخرى خلينا نعمل transcription لهذا الكلمة. potato. لاحظوا. potato. الآن مين أقوى؟ الأو ولا الأي؟ طبعا أي. أي ليه؟ لأنه هذه long vowel بينما الأو short vowel. potato. potato. هذا هو long vowel. فهو بيحكي القاعدة if the nouns have three syllables, if the third or the final one is weak, then we put, then it's unstressed. If the syllable preceding it is strong, we put the stress right here. potato. طب ليه ما حطينا في البداية؟ لأنه الـ A أقوى من الـ O. هذه قاعدة أولى. الثانية. If the second and third syllable are both weak, then the stress will go to the first syllable. مثل yesterday. لاحظوا هذه الجملة. Yes. Yesterday. 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 هذا week. طبعا هي day هنا week. Yesterday. 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 بيكون أضعف. فبيكون الستريس على البداية. أو مثلا innocence. Innocence. Bachelor. لاحظ هذه الكلمة. Bachelor. We have three syllables, this one should go to the first one. Okay? Bachelor. Wanderer. لاحظوا هذه الكلمة أيضا. Wander. Wanderer. Okay, شوه هذه ضعيفة، هذه ضعيفة، والاء أقوى تيجي في المقدمة. So if the second or the third syllables are weak, then we stress, we put the stress at the beginning. So to think, last syllables which are prominent, do they take the secondary stress? You can, if you want to think about this one or to study more, you just go to Peter Roach, page 100 in the textbooks, and you will find actually more explanation. So for here, it's very clear now. We have two rules. If the final syllable is weak or ends with a schwa, then it is unstressed. The syllable preceding it, so the then the syllable preceding it is strong. Okay, so the stress will go to the middle syllable. لكن إذا كان second and the third syllable are both weak, then the stress will go to the first syllable. بينما word stress patterns, here we're talking about complex words. Words made from basic word form, stem and affix. الآن من نحكي عن complex words. Stem اللي هو الجذر. والافكس اللي هو بيكون إما إضافة مثل prefixes أو suffixes. Okay. Compound words, words composed of separable root morphemes. هذا morpheme. Foot, ball. هذا بنسميه morpheme. المorpheme is the smallest semantic is the smallest semantic unit. يعني إنه لو قسمنا فوت وبول بتكون إلها نفس إلها معاني. فوت معنى قدم وبول بمعنى كرة. هذا each one is called morpheme. So morpheme is the smallest semantic unit in linguistics. بيختلف عن الفونيم. الفونيم is the smallest sound unit. بينما المورفيم is the smallest semantic unit. شو يعني smallest semantic unit؟ يعني إذا وقفت على حداها بتكون إلها معنى. مثل كلمة مثلا about أو كلمة مثلا an apple. an apple معناتها تفاحة. لكن لو قسمنا هذه الكلمتين صارت an هنا، هل إلها معنى؟ طبعا لا، فلازم تكون مع الأبل to make a meaning. So the morpheme is the smallest semantic unit. It has a meaning. في عندنا أيضا إشي بنسميه affixes. شو يعني الأفكسز؟ Sometimes in English مثلا نحكي play يلعب، بدنا نحكي لاعب شو لازم نحكي؟ player. شو أضفنا لplay؟ er. ال er هذا نسميها affix، بالتحديد suffix. play player، أو مثلا كلمة يكتب write، هذا الجذر. طيب بدي أحكي كاتب بضيف لها er بصير writer. ال er هذا بنسميه suffix. So prefixes comes before the stem. Okay, مثل possible ممكن، لكن غير ممكن impossible. أضفنا ما قبلها im أو prefixes. The suffixes comes after the stem. مثل happy سعيد. طب بدي أحكي سعادة، شو لازم نضيف للهابي؟ نس لازم نضيف، فبتصبح happiness. هذا بنسميه suffixes. طيب خلينا نشوف القواعد الصوتية لهذه الأشياء. We'll start first with the suffixes. خلينا نبدأ بالsuffixes. Suffixes carrying primary stress. دائما suffixes carrying primary stress. The primary stress is on the first syllable of the suffix. If the stem consists of more than one syllable, then its first syllable will take a secondary stress. A secondary stress. لاحظوا مثل كلمة Japan. 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 لاحظوا ج هذه شوى إجا المقطع، إجت الشوى على المقطع الثاني. الآن جابان أضفنا لها suffix. نحكي اليابان، نحكي ياباني شو لازم نضيف؟ E S E نصير Japanese. Japanese. لاحظوا الآن Japanese وين وضعنا الستريس؟ على suffix اللي هو النيز. النيز لأنه إيش؟ هي السافكس. وحكينا السافكس carry the primary stress، وهذا هو the primary stress. كان في مقطع في هذه الكلمة Japanese. Japanese كأكثر من مقطع صوتي. إذا كان في عندنا أكثر من مقطع صوتي the primary stress باخذ السافكس، والسكندري ستريس باخذه في بداية الجملة، بداية الكلمة. Japanese. Japanese. اوكي. طيب خلينا نشوف مقطع ثاني، صفق ثاني اللي هو الـ E. Refugee. هذا صفق. هي الأصل الجذر الكلمة refuge معناها لا يلجأ. Refugee لاجئ. لما أضفنا suffix جاء الستريس على suffix، بداية suffix، والsecondary بيجي في البداية. لأنه بتكون من أكثر من مقطع. بنروح على كلمة mountaineer. near هذا أيضا suffix. بأخذ the primary stress and the secondary stress should be at the beginning. Portuguese. Okay. Portuguese. نفس الشيء. Cigarette. مش cigarette. Cigarette. لأن ريت هذه هو السفكس هو الإضافة. هي الأصل كلمة سيجار. سيجار. لكن إذا أضفت لها السفكس eat لازم تحكي cigarette. يصير الضغط أو التركيز على المقطع الثاني. Cigarette. مش cigarette. Cigarette. والمثال الآخر أيضا. Picturesque. مش picturesque. لأنه إيسك هي suffix فالتركيز عليها لازم يكون. So suffixes carrying always primary stresses مثل ما وضحنا في الأمثلة. لكن there might be secondary stress on the first syllable if the noun has more than or if the word or the stem consists more than one syllable. لكن suffixes, there are some suffixes that do not affect stress placement. مثل conferable, encourage, refusal, widen, wonderful, amazing, devilish. لاحظوا كل هذه suffixes ما بتأثر على الستريس. بينما suffixes اللي أخذناهم قبل شوية النيز والإي والإي آر والإي تي والإيسك مجرد ما دخلوا الكلمة الستريس we put the stress on these suffixes. نضع التركيز أو الستريس أو الأكسنتويشن على suffixes. لكن في بعض suffixes they don't affect the stress placement. حتى لو أضفناهم على الكلمة ما بتغير مركز الستريس أو مكان الستريس. لاحظوا كل الستريس جاء في البداية. عفوا هنا. Comfortable, encourage, fusel, widen, wonderful, amazing, okay, devilish. So for verbs with the stem consisting more than one syllable, the stress is always on the syllable immediately preceding ish, مثل replenish. لكن في الأفعال اللي بيكون نهايتها هذه بس يعني بالنسبة للنون right here. For the verbs with the stem containing more than one syllable, the stress is always on the syllable immediately preceding the ish. مثل replenish. لكن هذه adjective. هذا مش verb. Because it is adjective, the stress should be at the beginning. لكن إذا كان verb, the stress should be in the preceded syllable. Suffixes that influence stress in the stem. In these examples, primary stress is on the last syllable of the stem. Advantages. Photography. لاحظوا هذه syllables كل ما دخلت على كلمة تجعل the primary stress on the last syllable of the stem اللي هو الجذر. Okay. يعني هذه الكلمة شو الأصل كان فيها الجذر؟ Photo كان الستريس هنا. لكن لما أضفنا graphy photo كانت تتكون من مقطع مقطعين. Photo. لما أضفنا graphy نقلت الستريس ووضعته هنا حتى أصبحت photography. واضحة؟ فكل ما دخلت هذه suffixes على الكلمات تنقل موقع الستريس للاست سيلابل. مثلا هذه الكلمة هي في الأصل climate، لما أضفنا الـ IC طبعاً كان الستريس في البداية، لما أضفنا الـ IC أصبحت climatic، كان climate مقطع مقطعين climate. لما أضفنا الـ IC نقلنا الستريس وأصبحت على المقطع الأخير فأصبحت climatic. أوكي، مثلا كلمة perfection، خلينا نأخذ كلمة perfection، هي في الأساس كانت perfect مقطع مقطعين، لما أضفنا الشين أصبحت الستريس على انتقلت لهنا. إذا هذه واضحة، قواعد واضحة، وحنعمل أمثلة كثيرة إن شاء الله في المحاضرات القادمة عنها. أما بالنسبة للـ prefixes بشكل سريع، effects on stress do not have comparative regularity, thus safe to say governed by the same rules as those for words without prefixes. Okay, so effects on stress do not have comparative regularity. For this reason, it's safe to say governed by the same rules as those for words without prefixes. So stems with hyphen, air ride, stems as one word, strawberry, stems as two words, disc clamps. Compounds with an adjectival first element and the ed morpheme at the end. For example, bad-tempered, half-tempered, heavy-tempered. دائما إذا كان في عندنا adjectival فهو بيكون في العادة الستريس على الموقع الثاني. هذا adjectival compounds، ماشي، compounds with an adjectival. فالfirst element هو بيكون الستريس. Compounds in which the first element is a number in some form also tend to have final stress. مثلا عندنا three wheels second class. فإذا وين ما وجدنا compound adjectival second element هو على الستريس. واضحة؟ compounds، شو يعني compounds؟ two things together مثل bad tempered half tempered بيناتهم هايفن بالعادة، مثل ما تشوفوا الهايفن الصغيرة هذا الخط، فبيكون الستريس على المقطع الثاني. compounds functioning as adverbs are usually final stressed. أما compounds اللي functioning as adverbs كظروف بيكون الستريس وين؟ finally، أيضا على الثاني. مثل head first هذا adverb جاء الستريس على الثاني. northeast برضو هذا ظرف مكاني، زي مكاني. downstream نفس الشيء بيجي الستريس على المقطع الثاني. compounds functioning as verbs and have an adverbial first element take the final stress adverbial. يعني هذا adverb ظرف ظرف مكان، هذا ظرف مكان، هذا ظرف حال، بينما grade فعل، pedal فعل، treat فعل. فالآن وين بيكون الستريس؟ بيكون برضو على المقطع الثاني. أوكي، في حال إذا كان في عندنا compounds functioning as verbs the final stress the stress will go to the final syllable to the final section. أوكي، فلاحظنا أنه معظم الـ compounds functioning as adjectival أو adverbs أو as verbs the stress goes to the final section. واضحة؟ I hope so. And here's kind of hint, some stress patterns change. Stress position may vary due to. ممكن أيضا موقع التركيز أو الـ relative emphasis ممكن يتغير حسب الحالات التالية، لكن هذه ما حنخوض فيها بشكل كبير. أريدكم أن تركزوا على الأشياء الأساسية لهذا الموضوع. The Swiss on other words occurring next to the word in a question. The stress on the other on other words occurring next to the word in a question. ممكن the stress position may vary due to the stress on other words occurring next to the word in a question. Example: stress on the final stress compound tends to move to a preceding syllable if the following word begins with a strongly stressed syllable. مثلا tam bad tempered. Bad tempered teacher. لاحظوا كان في عندنا bad tempered stress on لكن لما وضعناها في kind of different sentence or phrase أصبحت bad temper teacher bad temper teacher فأصبح الاسترس على the teacher. Not all the speakers by the way agree on the placement of the word. Okay, فcontroversy ممكن واحد يحكي controversy, others ممكن يحكوا controversy. Okay, فلذلك we are not going to focus on this topic, but I wanted you to just to understand sometimes you may have variable stress. يعني some people ممكن يحكوا بعض الكلمات مثل هذه الكلمة controversy, ممكن آخرين controversy. فلاحظوا الاختلاف في الاسترس, هذا بيعتمد حسب اللهجة وحسب الأشخاص, هذا ما تركز عليه لأنه له علم خاص في السوسيولينغوستكس في العلم الاجتماعي. Okay, let us now move on and see word class pairs. Two syllable words identical in spelling. هذا معناتها شو يعني word class pairs? What does it mean? Two syllable words identical in spelling differ from each other in their word class. Most of them are prefix stem. بالعادة هيك بكون. Their stress placement is also different. In other words, stress should be on the second syllable for the verbs, but on the first syllable on the for the nouns and adjectives. مثلا هذا الفعل نفس هذا permit. لاحظوا الاختلاف. لما احكي permit هي noun معناتها سماح, permit معنى يسمح, present معناتها مضارع أو هدية, لكن present معناتها يقدم صارت verb, produce noun معناتها منتج, لكن produce أصبحت verb. مثلا perfect معناتها تمام, لكن إذا حكيت perfect هيك noun, لكن إذا حكيت perfect وضعت stress على effect هنا بتصير verb. هذا حبيت إن أنوهكم لاستخدامات الword class pairs. هذا باختصار ملخص لكل شيء أخذنا اليوم. إن شاء الله for next class we will have practical class مليء بالتمارين عن الستريس word stress بالتحديد. تحدثنا اليوم عن النونز والفيربز, كيف where is the stress should be, if the noun is two syllables the stress should be on the first syllable, if the verb also consists of two syllables the stress should be on the last syllable. أيضا we have talked about the compound nouns, compound adjective, compound verbs. حكينا في the compound nouns the syllable should be on the first part. حكينا on the compound adjective and compound verbs the stress should be on the last part. في the compound nouns the stress should be on the the first syllable, like on the first part عفوا. بينما في the compound لاحظوا في فرق ما بين syllable part. في الكومباوند nouns في عندنا two words together, one part, second part, we put the stress on the first part. لكن في الكومباوند adjective والكومباوند verbs we put the stress on the last part, مش last syllable, last part. مثل understand كم عندنا two parts, ما حكيت syllables. Okay, أيضا we have talked about some of the phrasal verbs like turn off, pickle up, hand out. We put the stress on the particle. شو الparticle بالعادة بيكون حروف الجر. Okay. أيضا we have talked about the suffixes and the prefixes. حكينا some of the suffixes do change the meaning, do change the placement of the stress, the accentuation. لكن some other suffixes do not change the placement of stress. أيضا تحدثنا عن the prefixes. All the prefixes do not change. Most of them do not change the place of stress. Okay, and right here, you have the examples. If you have the IC or shins, you can put the stress on the syllable before the ending. لكن إذا عندك هذه الأمثلة أو هذه المقاطع, you should put the stress on the third from the last syllable. هذا أيضا إعادة ال word stress in different ways. For next class, inshallah, we will also talk more and have examples more about the word stress. For the sentence stress in English, we have, as we said last time, we have content words وفي عندنا structure words. دائما الستريسد في الإنجليزي هي ال contents words. بينما ال unstressed اللي هي ال structure words. شو يعني content words؟ ال content words, these are important words that carry the meaning, اللي بتحمل المعنى. بينما ال structure words, they are unnecessary because they correct the sentence, they put the sentence grammatically. فأحيانا الجملة من غير قواعد قد تكون مفهومة because of the content. لكن so if we remove the structure words, the sentence is still intelligible. You can understand it. بينما إذا حذفنا ال content words, the sentence will not be understood. لاحظوا هذا المثال. Sell, car, gun, friends. These are all content words. Sell هذا فعل, car, gun, friends. كل هذه contents words. You can understand the meanings. There is a car has been gone to France. Okay, لكن sell my car. I have gone to France. All of these. If you delete it, these are structure words. They are used to make this sentence grammatical. لكن إن حذفناهم الجملة مفهومة. هذه content words or هذه structure words. ونفس الشيء هذه. وهذه 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 كل structure words. If you delete them, if you remove them, the sentence is understandable. فهنالك rules for sentence words in English. We will explain this after we have a practical class for the word stress. The basic rules for sentence words are: content words are stressed. الكلمات اللي بيكون فيها ال content words are stressed, while structure words are unstressed. The time between stressed words is always the same. طيب ممكن واحد بيسأل شو هي ال content words in English? What are the structure words? ال content words في الإنجليش ممكن يكون main verb, nouns, adjectives و adverbs و negative auxiliaries. هذول كاملين stressed. في السنتنس أنا بحكي على مستوى الجملة الآن, وهذا حنناقشه في المحاضرات القادمة إن شاء الله. بينما الضمائر وحروف الجر والارتيكلز وأدوات العطف والأفعال المساعدة, هذه بنسميها structure words unstressed. يعني لو حذفتهم من الجملة الجملة تبقى مفهومة بعض الشيء. لكن لو حذفت ال content words, إذا حذفت ال content words, the sentence will be غير مفهومة, ununderstood. Hopefully today I have explained more about word stress theoretically. Next class is going to be practical class, so get ready, study what I have given you today, the rules for word stress. بدي تقرأوهم جيدا, study them very well, because next class is going to be practical one. Thank you so much for listening. Wa assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.